With giant beers, massive tents, and millions of revelers from around the world, there's no party quite like Oktoberfest in Munich, the largest beer festival in the world. Hi, I'm Christina from happytowander.com, and I lived in Munich for over 5 years. Wait, something's missing. That's better. Now, in the years that I lived in Munich, I must have gone to Oktoberfest dozens of times, visiting every single tent and getting to know the festival maybe a little too well. So if you're lucky enough to be going to Oktoberfest this year, make sure you watch this video because I'm going to be sharing all sorts of must-knows, ranging from the festival layout and what to eat and drink, all the way to how to not piss off locals as a respectful tourist. If you're looking for more practical planning tips, be sure to check out the planning guide I've linked in the description. But for now, let's start with some basic Oktoberfest must-knows. Now, the dates of Oktoberfest do vary year by year, but generally speaking, the festival takes place in the 2.5 weeks leading up to the first Sunday of October, unless that day comes before October 3rd, which is German Unity Day, at which point the festival does end on the 3rd. This means, yes, the majority of Oktoberfest does in fact take place in September. The festival is held every year in Munich, Germany, on the festival grounds known as the Theresienwiese, which is a large open space just southwest of the city center. And this is where the Oktoberfest has been celebrated since 1810, when it was originally the wedding celebration of King Ludwig I to Princess Therese of Saxe-Hildburghausen, the very princess after which these grounds, Theresienwiese, are named, because it literally means Therese's meadow. Now, this is where the local name for Oktoberfest, the Wiesen, comes from. In fact, if you go to Oktoberfest, you'll often find that locals will call it the Wiesen rather than Oktoberfest, unless of course they're speaking to tourists. So if you want to sound local, go ahead and say you're headed to the Wiesen instead of to the Oktoberfest. And if you're wondering how much it costs for a ticket, I have some excellent news. Admission to Oktoberfest is actually 100% free. The bad news is, unless you're just going in to take a look around, it's gonna cost you quite a bit of money to do pretty much anything else, with a standard mass of beer costing anything between 13 to 15 euros before tip. Now, enough of the boring stuff like prices. Why don't we go over a brief overview of the festival grounds so that you can know what to expect. Now, when people think of Oktoberfest, their minds automatically jump to giant beer tents, but in reality, that's only one portion of the festival. You see, Oktoberfest is what Germans call a Volksfest, which is something that combines both a beer or wine festival element along with a traveling fun fair. This means that while Oktoberfest can look like this, it can also look like this. On and around the sprawling grounds of the Theresienwiese, there are a few different landmarks you can use to orient yourself and find the right exit when the time comes. First off, on the western side, there's the Lady Bavaria statue, which sits on top of these steps, alongside the Ruhmeshalle, or the Hall of Fame, which features busts of important figures from Bavaria and other nearby regions. This is the exit closest to the Schwanthalerhöhe U-Bahn station. Fun fact, Lady Bavaria is actually hollow, and you can climb her to get to one of the coolest and most unique views of the festival. Now, this green area on the hill by here is known as the Kotzhügel, or Vomit Hill, and it's infamously where people go to puke, so definitely not where you want to end up. There's also St. Paul's Church to the north, which is just behind the Theresienwiese U-Bahn station, and the Ferris wheel slash Munich looping roller coaster, which are both typically on the south side of the grounds, closer to the Pochistrasse U-Bahn station. In the southwest corner is an amazing paid section of the festival known as the Oude Wiesen, which is modeled after what the festival would have looked like traditionally back in the day. It does cost 4 euro for entry, but once you get inside, the rides are only 1.50 euro each, so it's not a bad deal, and the vibe there is just really distinct and really wholesome and definitely worth checking out. Do note that every 4 years, however, this bit of the festival does take a break to accommodate the Zentrallandwirtschaftsfest, or the Central Agricultural Fair, which will next take place in 2024. At Oktoberfest, there are 17 large tents as well as 21 smaller tents, which are pretty much hidden in plain sight. In fact, a lot of the food vendors that you see at Oktoberfest that look like this actually conceal smaller tents just behind, which is actually where a lot of locals will book their tables so that they can kind of avoid the tourist crowds. In addition to indoor seating areas, there are also outdoor spaces. Many tents will also have beer gardens, and there are some unique standalone venues as well, like my personal favorite, which is the Weiss Beer Carousel. And scattered around the grounds are various fairground games, rides, food and drink stalls, as well as vendors selling miscellaneous souvenirs. All in all, the Theresien Wiese is a huge site that's impossible to fully cover in one visit. It can be quite overwhelming, but I'm hoping this portion of the video helped you kind of get your bearings. Now, to run through the flow of the day then, this is what a typical day at Oktoberfest would look like. First off, you enter the grounds through one of seven main entrances. On weekends, I'd strongly recommend arriving well in advance of the opening time because you're gonna have to make a run for it. The tents get extremely busy. Again, if it's a weekend, I would go straight to a tent. Make sure you kind of have a tent in mind and which one you wanna go for because there's not gonna be a lot of time for browsing. If, however, it's not very busy and it's a weekday, feel free to take a look around, kind of browse the different tents, play a few games, have a look at the site before you settle on a tent. Once you're in a tent, if you don't have a reservation, look for an empty table. The tables that are already reserved will be reserved with a white piece of paper that tells you the time from which it's going to be reserved. If you're lucky, you might actually find an empty table where the people haven't arrived yet for the reservation, in which case that's fair game, just know that you're going to have to vacate it as soon as they do arrive. And if there are no fully free tables, then don't be shy. Feel free to ask any half-empty tables if you can squeeze in at the end. Of course, this is gonna be way easier if you're a small group, like two or three people, but this is part of the Oktoberfest experience, so get ready to make some new friends. Once you're seated, a server will come and take your order. Make sure you know what you want in advance of your server arriving, just because efficiency is key. They're not gonna wanna wait around for you to look at a menu and try to make a decision. You will pay once the server comes back with your order. Make sure to tip on top of your total because you want to keep your server happy. They're most likely going to be your server for the rest of the evening, so I'd really recommend tipping quite generously on this first round. And to do that in Germany, basically you would tell them the total that you want to pay, including tips. So let's say, you know, your order is 15 euro, you want to tip 3 euro, then you would say 18, give them a 20 euro bill, and then they'll know to give you the change for the 2 euro there. Then finally, with your beers in hand, get ready to enjoy and have a great time. Usually during the day, the music is going to be folksier, it's going to be a lot of brass bands, but around 4 or 5 o'clock, that's when the switchover happens and they're going to be cover bands doing rock songs, really famous hits, and people start dancing on the benches and it's such a fun time. Lastly, don't forget to eat and hydrate. As of 2023, there are actually free water fountains installed around the festival site, so make sure you take advantage of those. Now, let's discuss another hot topic, which is what to wear. Now, as a tourist, is it mandatory to wear traditional clothes to Oktoberfest? The answer is no. There are going to be plenty of people, locals and tourists alike, who are just dressed in regular clothes rather than traditional ones. Now, the flip side of that, however, is you will probably feel quite left out. That said, traditional clothes, at least quality ones, do not come cheap. So if you'd much rather save your money for more beer, then there's zero shame in that. I would say it makes a lot more sense to just wear casual clothes rather than buy cheap or costumey versions of the traditional clothes, just because that can be quite offensive and also you won't look very good. So yeah, save your money. If you're gonna do traditional clothing, make sure you do it right. Now, what are these traditional outfits that people wear to Oktoberfest? Well, at the festival, men typically wear lederhosen, also known as leather pants. A good pair of authentic lederhosen are meant to last a lifetime, which is why they can be incredibly expensive. Lederhosen are usually paired with nice button-up shirts, and checkered colored shirts like these are quite common to see. But that said, white is actually more traditional and preferred by a lot of locals, especially older ones. Women at Oktoberfest typically wear these dresses known as dirndls. In reality, dirndls are composed of three separate components. Firstly, the blouse. Secondly, the dress. And third, the apron. Lengthwise, dirndls tend to be knee length or longer. The super short ones tend to be frowned upon because they can look quite cheap and costumey, so be sure to get ones that are of a proper length. And it's worth noting that the side that you tie your apron bow on actually can be indicative of your relationship status. So if you have it on the left, that means that you're single and ready to mingle, or if you tie it on the right, that means that you are taken. Moving on, it's time to discuss Oktoberfest drinks. Now, because it's Oktoberfest, there's a little surprise that beer is king. Beers at this festival are served in 1-liter vessels known as masses, or a mass. The most common type of beer consumed at Oktoberfest is known as a Helles, a light beer. This is what you'll tend to get if you just order beer and you don't specify which one you want. Beer at Oktoberfest is especially brewed for the occasion by Munich's Big Six breweries. And it's important to note that these beers are actually stronger than regular beers, with approximately 6% alcohol content. Tents will typically serve only beer from one brewery, which means that you won't be choosing a brewery when you pick your beer. So if you're hoping to get a sample of the different breweries in Munich, you're gonna have to tent hop a little bit. Now, if you don't like beer, you can also give something called a Radler a try. These are 50-50 mixes of beer and lemon soda. They're very delicious, very refreshing, and a great drink to try if you're not typically into the beer taste. It's also really good if you want to pace yourself. Now, there are also some tents that serve wine, including Kufler's Weinzelt, which is literally just a tent dedicated to wine. That said, the vibe in this tent is definitely different from the big beer hall ones, so I would highly recommend at least trying some beer. You never know, Bavarian beer is delicious and it might convert you. Apart from beer and wine, you'll also find different stalls around the festival site selling spirits and cocktails, but just don't expect too much variety within the tents themselves, because those are definitely mostly beer zones. Of course, there are non-alcoholic options as well, but if you're looking to try something a bit more local, then I can definitely recommend Apfelschorle, which is a half apple juice, half sparkling water combination, as well as Spezi, which is a half cola and half Fanta combination. Both of these are really popular local soft drinks and they're both very delicious. Now, almost as important as Oktoberfest drinks is Oktoberfest food. Food at Oktoberfest is delicious and plentiful, but it is incredibly expensive. Each of the tents will offer food menus, but you'll also find stalls selling grab-and-go foods all around the festival. A great way to dine cheap at Oktoberfest is taking advantage of lunch specials. A lot of different tents will have these from Monday to Friday, so if you stop in for the afternoon, you can take advantage of lunch deals where you can get a full plate of food for something under 15 euros, which is actually a very good deal for the festival, because at regular price, you're looking at probably 15 to 20 euro minimum for some of the main dishes. Now, in terms of must tries, here are some Oktoberfest dishes that you definitely need to put on your list. There's of course the classic Wiesenhändel, which is a roasted chicken. Delicious roasted pork like Schweinbraten or Schweinhaxe, pork knuckle. Obatzta, a tasty cheese dip that goes amazingly with a large bretzel or pretzel. Käsespätzle, which are bouncy little dumplings slathered in cheese and fried onion. And for snackier bites, I love getting a Steaksemmel, which is a steak sandwich you can get from many of the small stalls around the festival site, as well as sausages of all kinds. There's Weisswurst, which is a breakfast sausage. Make sure you peel the skin if you get these. And there's also Currywurst, which is not really Bavarian, but it's still really delicious. It's sausage served with curried ketchup, usually with a side of fries. Now, if you're craving something sweet, a few recommendations include Dampfnudel, which is a giant pillowy soft loaf of sweet bread that is served in a decadent vanilla sauce. Kaiserschmarrn, a fluffy shredded pancake that's dusted off with powdered sugar and other fixins like applesauce. And gebrannte Mandeln, which are roasted almonds that are cooked in sugar and so, so good. Now, it's important for you to know though that when it comes to must-eats, one thing that you need to avoid are these gingerbread cookies. You'll see them all over Oktoberfest, but don't eat them, they don't taste good, and the reason for that is because they're actually meant for decoration. So if you want a really cute souvenir, make sure you get one of these gingerbread cookies, but do not eat them, and make sure whoever you're gifting it to knows that as well, because it's such a waste. They're built to last, not built to eat. Now let's discuss some basic Oktoberfest vocabulary for your visit. I'm gonna be completely honest and say that Oktoberfest is such a touristy affair these days that most servers and people who work there will speak enough English to know how to take your order and how to have a basic conversation with you. So being able to speak German isn't super crucial to your experience, but of course it's always fun to learn a bit of the local language, and it is of course more respectful and more polite to be speaking the local language wherever you go. So with that in mind, here are some basic must-knows for your Oktoberfest trip. Now, a very basic Bavarian greeting that essentially means hello is Servus. To say bye, you just say Tschüss. Thank you is of course Danke. And Bitte is a word that means many things, but most predominantly it means please. It can also mean excuse me or Bitte, as in there you go ahead of me. So yes, it has a lot of different meanings, but if you want to say please, then that would be Bitte. To say excuse me, that would be Entschuldigung. Very importantly, to say cheers is Prost, and make sure you make eye contact when you're cheersing. They're very particular about that. To ask if this spot is free, you can ask Ist hier noch frei? To say a mass of beer, please, you would say Eine Mass Bier, bitte. And to say another mass of beer, please, you know, if you're doing a second or third order, then you would say Noch eine Mass Bier, bitte. All right, with that lingo out of the way, now let's discuss some survival tips for when you actually arrive to the festival. First of all, pack light. Big bags and backpacks aren't actually allowed on the festival grounds, and there aren't any coat checks within the festival. There's only a very small coat check outside the festival grounds and lockers at the train stations, so make sure you pack incredibly light, and also don't bring anything that you can't stand to lose, because to be honest with you, when you bring a bag, you're literally just gonna be leaving it on the ground, so there's a lot of margin for things getting misplaced, let's say. Now, another tip, especially if the weather is bad and you've brought a jacket with you, is to, when you sit down, tie your jacket to the leg of the table. That way, it's not going to be sitting on the floor and you're going to be able to find it quite easily by the time you are stumbling out to leave. Another important one is to bring cash, especially coins. So at this festival, cash is still very much king. So bring a lot of cash, more cash than you think you need, because unfortunately, Oktoberfest is very expensive. And also make sure you're bringing coins with you when you go to the bathroom, just because there are bathroom attendants that are the unsung heroes of the festival. They keep the bathrooms ridiculously clean, considering how many millions of drunk people are using them at once. So make sure you bring some coins to leave a tip for the bathroom attendants. Also remember to pace yourself, because as I mentioned, the beers at this festival are stronger than normal beers, and you're also consuming them by the liter. So if you don't want to be in bed by 2 p.m., make sure you're pacing yourself, drinking some water, maybe having a Radler in between, and not overdoing it. Next, don't forget about all the cool events that take place at the festival itself. Many first-time visitors don't realize that there's a full schedule of fun events that happen, including the Parade of the Landlords and Breweries on the first day, the traditional costume and hunters parade on the first Sunday, and other events like the traditional landlord concert and closing day gun salute. There's even special family days with discounts for children and families. So be sure to plan around those if you want to see another side of the festival. Make sure you also have a designated meeting spot in case you lose your friends. Honestly, if you're going to Oktoberfest in a group, it is quite inevitable that you and your friends are going to lose each other, whether they get lost trying to find their way back to the table or they get chatting with other people. It's very easy to lose them. So make sure you have a designated meeting spot at a certain time in case you lose each other, because the phone service in those tents is not good. And if you're looking to get a souvenir mask, then you can actually buy these from the gift shops on site and they can wrap it up for you. A lot of people do try to steal these masks, but most of the time security does catch them. So just keep that in mind. They don't take kindly to people trying to steal the masks. And lastly, don't stand on a table and chug a mask if you don't want to get kicked out. I know that these videos are very popular. You'll often see people chugging an entire beer to rapturous applause, but what the videos don't show is actually after they chug the beer, security is literally right there immediately and they get escorted out, which isn't fun. So just don't do that, because it's a waste of beer. All right, I hope this guide to Oktoberfest was helpful. And if you're looking for planning resources, be sure to check out the planning documents in the description below. Thanks so much for watching. For more practical travel videos just like this one, be sure to like and subscribe for more. I'll see you guys next week. Bye.